at most until he's at least 5 years old. But I am five. I'm more than five. Oh, well, that's the way it goes.
The only thing wrong with my big brother Charlie Brown is his lack of confidence. His inferiority and his lack of confidence. His clumsiness, his inferiority and his lack of confidence. His stupidity, his clumsiness, his inferiority and his lack of confidence.
Did you know that Charlie Brown has never pitched a winning baseball game, never been able to keep a kite in the air, never won a simple game of checkers, and never successfully hunted a football? Sometimes I marvel at his consistency. You have humility.
Thank you. Lunchtime is amongst the worst times of day for me. Always having to sit here alone. Of course, mornings aren't so pleasant either. Waking up and wondering if anyone would really miss me if I never got out of bed. And then there's the nights too, when I think about all the stupid things that I've done. And then the hours in between, when I do all those stupid things. Well, lunchtime is amongst the worst times of day for me. I better see what I've got. Peanut butter. Some psychiatrists say that people who eat peanut butter sandwiches are lonely. I guess they're right. And sometimes when you're really lonely, the peanut butter sticks to the roof of your mouth. Boy, the PTA sure did a good job of painting these benches. There's that little redheaded girl eating her lunch over there. I wonder what she would do if I went over and asked if I could have lunch with her. She'd probably laugh right in my face. It's hard on things when it gets laughed at. There's an empty place right next to her on the bench. There's no reason why I couldn't just get up and sit over there. All I have to do is stand up. I'm standing up. I'm sitting down. I'm so much of a coward. I'm so much of a coward, she won't even think of looking at me. Why shouldn't she look at me? Is she so great and I'm so small that she can't spare one single moment? She's looking at me. She's looking at me.
No, Sally. You're thinking of the other dress. The one I wore to Lucinda's party. The one I'm talking about is the very light blue one. It had a design embroidered around the waist.
I don't remember.
It looked something like this. It was supposed to have like this. It had puffy sleeves and a sash like this. Oh yes, I remember. Yes. Well, that was the dress I was wearing the other day when I met Frida, and she told me she saw one just like it.
Lunchtime is amongst the worst times of day for me. If I take off this bag and she's looking at me, she'll think I'm a fool. On the other hand, if she's not looking, maybe I could just quickly take it off and she'd never know. On the other hand, it's very hard to breathe in here. She's not looking at me. I wonder why she never looks at me. Oh well, one more lunch hour. Only 2,863 to go!
marriage with a musician.
Happiness is a fleeting thing, Zelda, but I think that a man can really come closer to it by directing the forces of his life towards a single goal that he believes in. And I think that a man's personal search for happiness isn't really a selfish thing either, because by finding happiness himself, he can help others to find it. Does that make any sense to you?
We had spaghetti at our house 3 times this week.
Thank you.
Thank you. age, it can only come to the throne after the death of the reigning monarch. I can't think of any possible way to become queen. I'm sorry, but it's true.
Kind of hope it's in the sky. Believe it's to me to have the one. What's it doing? It isn't on the ground. It isn't in a tree. It's in the air. Look at that. It's Calvary now. It's past the trees now. With room to spare. Oh, what a beautiful sight. And I'm not such a clumsy guy. If I really try, I can really fly.
How are you doing today, Sally?
I'm mad at the whole world.
Well, are you mad at everybody in the whole world?
I'm mad at everybody.
Well, are you mad at all the animals and the birds and the fish? How about all the trees and the flowers?
I'm mad at them too. I'm mad at everything.
Well, are you mad at the sky and the stars? How about the ground and all those little rocks? Are you mad at the cars and the TVs and the buildings? How about bracelets and circuses and roller skates?
You didn't mention jump ropes.
Are you mad at jump ropes?
I'm especially mad at stupid jump ropes!
For you, Lucy. Happy Valentine's Day. No, that doesn't seem right. Here, Lucy, this is for you. Happy Valentine's Day. You can do it if you just don't get nervous. Okay, here she comes. This is for you, Lucy. Merry Christmas.
I've been thinking, my brother, as to why you didn't get any help. I think I figured it out. You didn't get any Valentine's because nobody sent you any.
Ha! Look at them laughing and enjoying themselves with their Valentines. I sent a Valentine to everybody I know this year. And did I get one in return? No. Not one single Valentine. I get about as many Valentines as a dog. My stomach hurts. I'm not very handsome or clever or lucid, stupid at spelling and numbers. I've never been much playing football or baseball or stickball or checkers or marbles or ping pong. I'm usually awful at parties and dances. I stand like a stick, or I cough, or I laugh, or I don't bring a present, or I spill the ice cream, or I get so depressed that I stand in ice cream.
Art, do you hear me? Art, 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 art.
born 1770, died 1827. Elvis of three sons.
Oh, my answer! Schroeder, I want you to know I'm on your side. I want to help you publicity wise with Beethoven's birthday. After all, this is a really big thing.
Thank you for support, Lucy, but I just don't want to see Beethoven's birthday commercialized.
Commercialized?
Yes. The next thing you know, they'll be wearing Beethoven t-shirts.
anticipate. Sometimes, when you're unusually depressed, you may even have to switch arms.
Start writing now, but if I start writing now, when
story of Peter Rabbit, which this report is about.
World War I, something flying with me. Back at the air dome in France.
you telling me?
What?
Why are you telling me?
Why are you telling me? I like it. That's your philosophy. Why are you telling me?
I can't stand it.
What's the sense in our playing
win anyway when we know we're going to lose? If there was even a 1,000,000-to-1 chance in our winning, it would make some sense.
Yeah.
Well, there may not be a 1,000,000-to-1 chance, but there's gotta be a 1,000,000,000-to-1 chance.
Yeah.
Come on, give me a T.
T.
Give me an E.
E.
Give me an A.
A.
Give me an F.
F.
What have you got?
Yeah.
I'm the best team. We should party right here. We will show you we're the best team in the dirty little week this year. When it comes time, we'll be big time. With the big, big baseball stars. For all we have to do is win just one more game. And the championship is in front.
Dear pen pal, you'll never guess what happened today at the baseball.
Your crabbing suggests about everyone you meet. And it's true, it's just the same. Now, I hope that you're able to take this in the spirit that it was intended, because I think it's good for us to be able to learn a little bit more about ourselves. I think Socrates was 100% correct when he said, the first thing any person should do is learn to know thyself. Well, I hope I haven't said too much or offended you.
Well, who was Socrates anyway, huh? What did she do anyways? Did she ever get to be queen? Tell me that! Did she ever get to be queen? Did she ever get to be queen? Well, who was Socrates anyway, huh? Know thyself.
Hey, Snoopy, better come out here and get my arm back in shape. This one's my new fastball.
Excuse me, Uncle Charlie Brown, but there are a few questions I'd like to ask you, if you don't mind.
Certainly, Lucy.
Well, I'm conducting a survey to enable me to know myself better. And first of all, I'd like to ask, on a scale of 0 to 100, using a standard of 50 as average, 75 as above average, and 90 as exceptional, where would you rate me on regards to crabbiness?
Well, Lucy, that's a very hard question to answer.
Your balance need not be signed, and your answers will be held in strictest confidence.
Well, still, Lucy, that's a very hard question to answer.
You may have a few moments to think it over, or we can come back to that question later.
I think I'd like to come back to it later, if you don't mind.
This next question deals with certain character traits you may have observed. And regarding my personality, would you say that I am A, forceful, B, pleasing, or C, objectionable? Would that be A, B, or C, Charlie Brown? Would that be A, B, or C? Which one would be, Charlie Brown? Huh?
A.
Charlie Brown! A, B, or C?
A, forceful.
Forceful. I see. Well, put a check mark next to the letter A then. Now, would you rate my ability to get along with other people as poor, fair, good, or excellent?
Do you have a place for abstention?
Certainly! I'll just put a check mark next to none of the above. Now, this next question deals with physical appearance and referring to my beauty. Would you say that I am A, stunning,
mysterious,
or intoxicating?
I mean, gee, Lucy, do you look just fine to me?
Stunning! All right, Charlie Brown. I think we should get back to that first question. On a scale of 0 to 100, using a standard of 50 as average.
I remember the question, Lucy.
Well?
Thank you.
3.
See the street.
are alive, a withering, hollow shell of a dog. And there lies my suffrage, empty. But that's all right. He'll remember. When no great friend comes to greet him after school, then he'll remember. There'll be nothing left but the dry carcass of a former friend that used to laugh and play so happily with him. Nothing but the bleach, the puppy.
Hey, Snoopy, are you asleep or something? I've been standing here for a whole minute with your supper.
Or a satellite.
Or a satellite.
I learned just by sitting here.
Wait, where are you going?
Kidding, you loser look.
You know, I like to sit up here after supper time and listen to the silence of the night. But I feel like something's missing. In my opinion, that's exactly what it is.
I'm so happy. That little redheaded girl dropped her pencil. It has teeth marks all over it. She nibbles her pencil. She's human. Happiness is finding a pencil.
Pizza with sausage. Sharing the turn.